In this video, we are going to use the SunFounder's ESP32 and ESP32 extension module with soil moisture sensor to measure the soil moisture. And we are going to practically check the moisture on our plant, and we will turn on a buzzer if the level of moisture is lower than expected. And if I immerse it again in this ESP32 starter kit from SunFounder. This is the best ESP32 learning kit from SunFounder. It has this ESP32 microcontroller, which has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. This board can do everything Arduino Uno can do or many other Arduinos can do, plus extra more features. Because we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, the possibilities are endless. You can get connected to the cloud or do the control or read information or values via your mobile device or your desktop or over the cloud from a far location. It comes with a camera extension kit where you can stream the video over Wi-Fi either through the cloud or to your network. And also it comes with micro SD card where you can save images on the micro SD card, or you can write from the device any information, log the information on the device and read it back. You can power the board using this included 18650 lithium battery, and it has built-in charger where you can connect micro USB and charge the battery. The kit comes with 320 pieces of component that you can learn tons of projects. Come to this page, docs.sunfounder.com. Scroll down until you see ESP32. Then click on ESP32 Starter Kit Main. On the left side, click on Arduino User. And then scroll to 5.9. Measure soil moisture. Click. This is the documentation for today's lesson. We are going to use a capacitive soil moisture sensor to measure the amount of moisture either in the soil or any other medium, and it can be used for irrigation, automation, plant health, or environmental sensing projects. For this project, we need ESP32 camera extension board, jumper wire, and soil moisture sensor module. If we click on this, and here is our moisture sensor, we make sure when you're working with this and immerse it in water or soil, you have to keep this in mind that this can get damaged. So make sure to not insert anything above this and protect this. And this is a wire that comes with this module. And we see the information here. The operating voltage is 3.3 to 5 volts. And we have just output VCC and ground 3 pins. On this module, we have this circuitry here. We have here a 555 timer IC. How it works is, if you look at the schematic, this is ground. This is the signal. And this is the VCC, the three wires. And these are the two plates that we have on the moisture sensor. This is our moisture sensor. This side is all copper, but this side we have this piece, and from here we have one big piece that is coming to this point, and from the diode we have another piece, which is this piece, the one that is connected to the diode, and the other one is the ground. So this piece is the ground, and then we have this. And as a result, the capacitance between this plate and this plate will change when you insert it in a medium like water or soil. And the capacitance will affect the output voltage waveform, and we can measure it as a voltage. The higher the soil moisture, the higher the capacitance of the sensor. As a result, the square wave have less reactance, which reduces the voltage on the signal line, because here we have a filter here with 1 nanofarad capacitor and 1 mega ohm resistor, and this capacitance will affect it, and so we will have the signal between ground and the signal pin used and increased depending on the moisture. And here, these are the suggested pins for this project. We are going to use pin 35. Here is our module schematic, pin 1 ground, and then VCC is connected to 3.3 volts, and we are using the A-out connected to 35, which we will measure analog out. So this is A-out. Here is the actual wiring, which I'm going to show you, and this is a simple code. We are going to have two codes. In the second project, we will use this to take action based on some amount of moisture. When you use ESP32 with SunFounder's ESP32 camera extension module like this, it comes also with a battery on the package, and it comes a built-in charger, so you can connect it and charge it and disconnect, and later on you can use it with a lot of power, so you can power up your application very easily. When you're using the moisture sensor, make sure to protect it. This area should be protected from water. And here is the wire that I'm connecting. We have three wires. Red is 3.3 volts, black is ground, and this is the analog output from this pin. And if you're using ESP32 without extension board, you just connect the wires to 3.3 volts and ground on this side, and 35 is in here. They've been also labeled here, but I'm using this extension board, the SunFounder's extension board. So if I insert it, also I can power it up with a battery. But here I've also connected them through the screw, so they are very secure. Ground and 3.3 volt is here, and this is 35. And let's just insert it. I put them in the same order. Yellow is to yellow, and red is to red, and brown is to the black. And the wiring is completed. I'm opening Arduino IDE. Let's open our project by clicking on File, Open. On the left side, click on Downloads. Then ESP32 Starter Kit Main on the right side. Double click to open it. Double click on C. Double click on Codes. Scroll down until you see 5.9. Moisture, double click on this folder, and then 5.9 moisture is the file. Select it and click open. And here is our code. We inside the setup, we have only one line which defines the serial monitor with 115,200. And inside the loop, which runs continuously, we have three lines. This line is reading using analog read, the pin 35. The value from here is from 0, it's from 0 to 4095, because this is a 2 to the power 12, and that will be the value minus 1. So the result will be stored in this variable called analog value, and this is just printing analog value. From here to here we have a text, analog value, and this percent and D will get the value, this variable, and it will print it in one line, and we have 300 milliseconds, and the loop will come back and repeat all this over again. Now let's see how we can select the ESP32 board. We can click here under the select board and type here ESP32DEV. As soon as you type dev, you will see dev board. You can select it and click OK. So the board has been selected. Now we have to select the port. The other way to select the board is click on Tools, Board, ESP32, and select the ESP32 dev module. Now we have to select the port. If I click here, it shows two ports, and I don't know which one belongs to my device. Sometimes you will not see the number properly. So the best way to be sure, right click on the start menu, go to the device manager, and you will see here the ports. If I click on this arrow, it will show me the ports. One is USB serial CH340, one the other is USB serial device. And here, now it's connected. If I disconnect this, one of them disappear. The one that disappeared is my board. So 6 stays and 8 disappeared. If I connect it, so 8 is my COM port, CH340. Now 8 is my COM port and I can select it. Or I can click on tool port and here you will see it. You can select whichever you want. Ours is COM 8. Now we have successfully selected the board and the port. And this is very important. It must be done first. Now let me upload the code. Click. Wait for this to be completed. The code is uploaded. Let's open the serial monitor. Click here and pay attention that this number 115,200 must match here. If you have a different number like 9600, you will not be able to read actual data here. This is unreadable, so make sure that it's 115,200 so you can read the value. As you can see, we are getting 2500 or 2450, something like that. Even the module is not immersed in water or anything, but for sure if I bring my hand around this, we will get 1800, so the value changed. The capacitive around the plate is affecting this. Okay, now the board is here, so I'm leaving it so you can see it at least. And the value that we are reading is around 2000. I already have some water, and let's insert it. I'm gonna insert it up to here. Pay attention that we are reading 2500. Let's go down. Give it some time. And we are reading now 1600. So we are reading 1500. Now I have another plant. This is basil. I've not put much water in it. Let's see. And if I remove this, let's see what we are reading. So the value is back to 2500. Let's immerse it in this. This has less moisture and maybe it's a little dry. So as you can see, we are reading around 2000. Instead of 2500, this is 2000. So by comparing these two, you can find out which level means dry and which value means moist. So right now when I touch this, my hand is not getting wet. So this perhaps needs next day water, or maybe it needs water now. So if the number is reduced, it has a lot of water. Now I have a glass of water. And let me remove this. You will see that it will go back to around 2500. But let's see if I insert this in water. There is full water. And as you can see, we are reading 900. So full water means around 900. And as it gets drier, it will increase. So anything. So from these numbers, you can come up to take action, maybe turn the buzzer on, turn the pump on. So you know, for example, you can put a buzzer to inform you to water it. So now for the buzzer wiring, just keep the long pin on the right side, insert it on the breadboard, and get the red wire connected to the right pin, and get a black wire connected to the left pin. We already learned about this, so two pins should be empty in between it and your wiring is fine. The red is connected here to pin 13, because I use the pin 13 in the code, and this wire is connected to the ground, second pin here, or you can do it also second pin in here. Both of these are the same. And here's the code where we will take action when the amount of dryness or wetness increase or decrease. In this case, I'm paying attention if it is dry, and I've defined 1000 as dry, and I've defined a pin called buzzer pin, pin 13. And here I've added this buzzer pin using pin mode as an output. So this line is defining the pin 13 as an output. This code is executed only once inside the loop. I've added this conditional statement, if analog value, this value that we are reading, is less than dry, less than 2000, then we say print this on the screen and say dry, and then using digital write, the buzzer pin, set it to high, so the buzzer will buzz, and we know that the plant needs water. Of course, you can do it fancier and turn on a pump, but this is for simplicity. Else, it means, and we say it's wet, print wet, and then using digital write, we set the buzzer pin to low, so it's turned off. And the rest of the code is the same. Now let's check these two plants that we have here. Right now it is in the dry pot, and we are reading 1900, and because it is dry, I tested the values. I set the value for moisture to be any number above 2000 will be dry, and below 2000 will be wet. Now we are reading 1600, and this has water. That's excellent. And to understand it, better, again, let me just immerse it in water. So if I go inside water, it's way low, so it's too wet. That we are reading around 900. It just needs to get, and if I immerse it again in this, this has water, and anything, when the value is greater than 2000, it means that it is. So here, I put here 2000. If it is greater than 2000, it is dry. Now, it's not, so we are reading 1800, and the buzzer is not buzzing. And when I insert it, and here when I insert it in the in this dry module, you see, because I just changed it to 1800, and I said if the value is greater than 800, it is dry. So we are here, we are reading 800, and if I remove it, it's 2000. It says it's dry, and if I insert it in this module, it reads around 1600, so it's wet. So perfect, it works fine. So we learned that this pot does not need water, and our buzzer is not buzzing because the value is not greater than 1800. Now it's around 1400.